My name is Warren Pohl. I'm one of the co-founders at 33 Shake, and welcome to another episode of the 33 Shake vlog. Now, on today's episode, we are going to be talking all about plants and whether a plant-based diet has worthwhile benefits for athletes and your performance. And if it does, should you be trying it? Because while once upon a time they were the unloved fun spoilers on our plates, sports performance is fast waking up to the idea that the humble vegetable, along with beans, nuts, seeds, legumes, and fruit, could just be the font of a new breakthrough in performance levels. So part paleo, part vegetarian, part vegan, all performance. The name for this movement, if you want to call it that, is simple. It's called plant-based nutrition. A lot of high-profile athletes are switching over to it. There's a lot more talk about it in the media, but is there anything in it? And is it something that you should be doing? If you do want to, how can you go about it? That's exactly what we're going to be dealing with in today's show. Because at 33 Shake, we are all about delivering maximum value for endurance athletes. And we do it in these videos by sharing the very latest in training, mindset, racing, and nutrition knowledge for your performance. And we do it in store at 33shake.com with our awesome natural sports nutrition. With that out of the way, let's get into the world of plant-based nutrition. Basically, a plant-based diet as an athlete simply means eating tons of awesome veg, fruit, nuts, seeds, legumes, and berries to become an athletic demon who laughs in the face of injury and slays personal bests at will. Now, before you get too freaked out, being plant-based doesn't have to mean being fruitarian, raw, vegan, vegetarian, or any of those other tags that can cause social pariah status among your less performance-minded peers, and they can generally freak people out. And when it comes to the subject of food and what's on the plates, people can get pretty defensive, and those labels can be divisive. Plant-based simply means you're someone who likes to get more plant-based foods into your diet. Doesn't have to mean exclusion of anything, it's just I'm gonna eat more of this plant stuff as opposed to the other things. That's all there is to it. So whether you wanna go the whole way and just eat plants, or whether you just wanna eat a few more fruit and veg every now and again, cool's entirely up to you. Why should you even care about this? Well, because cutting down on animal products and filling up on plants is increasingly shown to have a huge number of athletic benefits and turn you into a total sporting rock star. There's just very good evidence that increasing this, reducing animal products, is gonna increase your energy levels, help your body recover faster from training load so you can train more or even just simply improve the performance based on the training you are doing. And it can improve immune function into the bargain, which is gonna mean that you're gonna spend less downtime being sick, more uptime having fun, training, living life. It's kind of a nice place to be. It's a really good thing for the planet too, because in short, growing plants for us to eat takes far less toll on the planet than animal agriculture. This is a short point. I think something like 70% of the agricultural land in America, off the top of my head, is used to grow the plants to feed the animals that we then eat. So, bit of food for thought there. Now, plant-based athletes at the highest level. There are a lot of them. Let's just run through a few examples. What about the legendary US ultramarathon runner, Scott Jurek? This is a man who has been a 7 times Western States 100-mile winner. That is the number one 100-mile ultramarathon event in the US, for those of you who aren't completely into your ultras. Very, very serious high-level competition there. He's a 3-time Spartathlon winner, double Badwater Marathon winner. For anyone who's wondering what the Badwater is, ironically, it's got the word water in it. It's actually, I believe it's 100-mile, it might be longer. It's through Death Valley. One of the hottest, driest places in the world. So he's won that twice. He has been 100% plant-based since 1999. Clearly it's working for him. At the shorter end of the running scale, you might remember a bloke called Carl Lewis. He was a 9-time Olympic gold medal winning sprinter. Fully plant-based since the start of his very most dominant season in 1991. He said this, "I've found that a person doesn't need protein from meat to be a successful athlete." Now we go on to the ultra-distance triathlete, serial Ultraman finisher, and a man that Men's Fitness magazine voted as one of the fittest on the planet in 2009, this guy called Rich Roll, completely plant-based since 2006 and puts his diet at the heart of his performance. He says, I'm able to repair my body and recover well from workouts, and I'm able to bounce back fresh day in and day out. And he puts this all down to the food. Also, his podcast, the Rich Roll podcast, is a great resource for anyone who's looking for further inspiration and ideas in the world of plant-based performance. Now, you could say, yeah, but look, all of those guys, they're all lightweight, skinny, ultra-distance athletes. You still must need meat and dairy products for power, right? Well, maybe not. Got an example for you here. Former world champion heavyweight boxer David the Haymaker Hay. Completely plant-based, that's what fueled the comeback that put him back into the top 10 heavyweight boxers of all time. I'm not going to argue with that bloke. As he puts it, I did some research to make sure I could still obtain enough protein to fight on a plant-based diet. And once I was satisfied that I could, I stopped eating animal products. I'll never go back. Another boxer, Anthony Joshua, the current unified heavyweight world champion, he increases his plant-based dietary meals as he gets nearer to fight time. So the closer he gets to a fight, the more plant-based he comes, becomes basically being entirely vegan in the lead up to the fight. Again, it's entirely performance related for him. Over in the NFL, American football players, David Carter, who plays in one of the largest and heaviest, hardest hitting positions on the American football field, he transformed his own performance, strength and recovery since he went entirely plant-based. As he is 21 stone of solid muscle, and as he says that since becoming plant-based, he's become faster, you could argue with him, just don't expect to outrun him or get away with it if the argument doesn't go your way. A few others, 23-time tennis Grand Slam winner Venus Williams, 4-time Formula One world champion Lewis Hamilton, Premiership footballer Jermaine Defoe, that's soccer for anyone listening in America, and legendary Italian rugby international Marco Bergamasco. The list goes on and on and on. So there's a lot of athletes doing this. But you know, maybe you could think, well, they're athletes, they have weird lives anyway, they can afford to do this, it's easier for them, it's just never going to really make it into the mainstream. Well, maybe. Remember that guy, Arnold Schwarzenegger? Did a bit of bodybuilding once upon a time, a couple of movies maybe. Governor of California, you know the guy, I'll be back, all that sort of stuff. Anyway, look, this is a man who coined the insult, you hit like a vegetarian. Even he has said publicly that we should all be eating less. Less meat, less animal products. And he says, you can get your protein source from many different ways other than animal products. When this kind of talk is coming mainstream, and literally he put this out on an advert, there's a bit of a shift going on in the air. So, if you think you'd like to get involved in making a shift towards becoming increasingly plant-based or simply trying it for a while, here's how you can do it. First of all, eat less meat, fish and dairy. Then eat more plants. It's actually as simple as that. Now, some people might say, that's a bit difficult. Okay, it's not, okay? If you want to try this, just need to toughen up a little bit, buttercup, and have a look. Here's a quick example menu of a way you could try all this. It's not fancy, it's not difficult to cook, it's not expensive. To be honest, actually, a plant-based diet is generally cheaper than one with animal products in it. And for those of you who don't have dishwashers, I can hear everyone in America going, what, people don't have dishwashers? Sorry for the Americans, that was a terrible accent. But yes, in a lot of parts of Europe, it's quite common not to have a dishwasher, particularly if you live in an apartment and space is tight. For those of you who don't, there is a point to this little dishwasher ramble here, which is that when you are on a plant-based diet, the washing up is much easier because without the animal fat, even though you're getting other fats, you know, you're still getting good fats in your diet. But without the animal fat in the products that you're cooking, doesn't matter how much you burn stuff, nothing sticks to anything. Anyway, maybe that's a metaphor for what could be going on inside as well. Maybe stuff's not going to stick to your insides as much, but I digress. We were saying, is it difficult to be plant-based or is it difficult to suddenly not eat animal products? Well, look at this as an example menu if you just wanted to trial this. Here's how easy it can be. Okay, our plant-based starter menu. Breakfast, porridge with almond milk and black coffee. Totally plant-based. Lunch, a massive salad. And for those of you, particularly those of us brought up in England who think that a salad basically means some kind of wilted lettuce with a bit of cucumber and tomato, you think, well, how am I going to get filled up on that? You've got to change your perception of salad. Throw almonds in there, throw a lot of chopped avocado in there, throw chickpeas in there, really start to beef the thing up. Courgette's a good chunky one to get in there. You know, when you chunk that salad up, there's an entire meal in there, promise you. And because you're getting so much more nutrient density out of your food, and because actually it's just bigger and bulkier because it hasn't been processed, it's going to fill you up really easily. So there's your lunch, great big salad. And you can have a glass of water with some lemon squeezed in it on the side. There you go, you are still totally plant-based. Meal number three, this is dinner. We are really going to knock the boat out because frankly, at the end of a long day, the last thing you want to be doing is coming home and go, what am I going to cook? I can't find anything. This is all complicated. That's the point where you give in and quickly get a takeaway. Beans on toast, people. That is totally vegan. Hold the cheese. That's all you got to do. That is a totally plant-based meal. Put olive oil on your toast instead of butter. Put chili flakes in your beans if you like that sort of thing, just to spice it up a little bit. And hey, why not have a glass of red wine to celebrate your first day of being completely plant-based? So there you go. Really easy one to experiment. If you enjoy this, make it like one meal a week. And you know, that gives you the time to work out some other recipes that you might like. Experiment it, see how it goes. Now look, we are not going to start writing meal plans and recipes here, unless, of course, you write in your thousands and go, please give us meal plans and recipes. We're here to help. And if that's what you want, that's what we'll do. But generally, there's a lot of great resources already out there. One we could suggest is a website called No Meat Athlete, all one word. They have got tons on there to get you started. And frankly, as far as we're concerned, all this is about is putting food for thought out there. All we want to see, we're up for anything that makes athletes faster, stronger, happier, and healthier. And as it happens, all 33 Shake products are completely plant-based. They always have been. I mean, this is not something we set out to do. When we started developing products and putting product out in 2012, like plant-based as a concept didn't even exist as far as we know. We'd certainly never heard of it. All we were looking to do was find the most powerful ingredients that we could use in our sports nutrition products to deliver maximum bang for buck. And what do you know? Every single time, these are from plant-based sources, and we get them from as close to the source as possible, so as little processing has gone on there, so you're getting the maximum of everything. So if you are staying on a plant-based journey, you want plant-based nutrition, well, hell, everything we make is plant-based and always will be. So there you go, look. If you want to take a step down this road, just know that Arnold Schwarzenegger, the Terminator, he would be very, very proud of you. Hope that's been helpful. Hope you've enjoyed it. And as always, let us know your thoughts, whether in the comments below or via social media or on our email. You'll find all of our contact details for those in the show notes. Is this something you want to try? Is this something you're interested in? Could you really not care less and you just love your steak too much? Do you know anyone who's had good results? Have you had good results? Have you tried it and did it all go wrong? Let us know. Like I said, it'd be great to have your feedback. And remember, if you are looking for the very best in sports nutrition for your endurance performance, whether it's for running, swimming, cycling, triathlon, well, you know where to come. 33shake.com. We're open 24/7, 365. Look forward to seeing you.